Is he just here for the day, or is that new? Oh, it's at every place where they're born?
No.
Okay. It's not quite like that. Okay.
No.
Good morning, and welcome all to St. Gertrude's. We're also happy to have you here today. Happy Father's Day, all you fathers and all you who father in many ways. Today we celebrate the 11th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We will be singing the Mass parts from the Mass of St. Anne, and all our hymns are being used with permission under license A728690. So please rise, greet one another so we can worship together as a family. And join in our opening hymn number 441, On Eagle's Wings. 441.
My rock in whom I trust.
upon eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of a fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under God's wings, your refuge, God's faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you in the palm of his hand.
Let us begin with the sign of our redemption, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Good morning. As has already been mentioned, happy Father's Day. There will be a special blessing for fathers, grandfathers, and those who have had a fatherly role in people's lives. All should feel free to come forward for this special blessing at the end of Mass. Our scriptures give us pause for wonderment at the power of the saving word of God and our faith that is a gift that has responded to the word of God and brings us here this morning. I'm probably a new face to some of you. I'm a Jesuit priest who has taught at Loyola. My name is Pete Bernardi, Father Pete Bernardi. Good to be with you this morning. My sisters and brothers, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our need for God's forgiveness, mercy, and strength. Lord Jesus, you grow the seed of faith in our souls. We know not how. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you call us to cultivate this gift and produce good fruit. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your kingdom grows in and among us by mystery and grace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Mighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and mighty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel, I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, and every winged thing in the shadow of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of our God.
God.
Numbers 786, my soul is thirsting for you, O God. 786. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. Oh, God, you shadow of your wings, I cling to you, and you hold me high. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. Through the day you walk with me, all the night your love surrounds me. To the glory of your name I lift my hands, I sing your praise. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. I will never be afraid, for I will not be abandoned, even soul is thirsting for you, my Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The seed is the word of God, Christ is the sower. All who come to God will live forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, that when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, Jesus spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them. But to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. What gives you pause for wonder, wonderment, astonishment, awe? Anything this past week that moved you to say, this is awesome? Anytime my brother sends a video of my two grandnieces that I baptized here in Chicago, they'll be 2 years old and 4 years old, big birthday bash planned in August. Adorbs. I'm just in awe of these two little ladies. What gives you pause for astonishment, wonder? The scriptures we've heard would have us in astonishment, in amazement, at the mysterious fecundity of the Word of God. I think we're all in wonderment when we see the pictures of deep space coming back from the James Webb telescope and its prior telescope, the Hubble, taking us back to pretty close to the origins of our known universe. I'm no astrophysicist, but they say something like a mustard seed exploded, the Big Bang Theory, and launched the universe on its odyssey with just the right calibration of forces that allows us to be here. Awesome. And each of us began as a mustard seed, that is to say, a fertilized egg, I guess the size of a mustard seed, and look at us now, how we gestated, developed. Awesome. And in the first reading from Ezekiel, this chapter in salvation history, when it looked so grim, the temple had been destroyed in 587 by the Babylonians. The chosen people, God's special ones, had been carted off into exile. Ezekiel speaks the word of God that gives hope. He says, God will take a small shoot, a twig, from a cedar tree, and from it will grow this awesome tree symbolic of the renewal of the people of God. They didn't lose their faith when they went through these dark times in the 6th century. Awesome. And then the mustard seed of our church, an itinerant Galilean preacher in a remote corner of the Roman Empire with a ragtag group of followers who dies a tortured death like many other seditionists and revolutionaries that the Romans wanted to put down. From that little mustard seed beginning, the church was founded. And here we are, 2,000 years later. There's no institution in human history that can rival the survival of our church. And it's gone through some dark times, and even recently. But here we are. The seed of faith has been planted in our hearts. The faith that St. Paul refers to in the second reading. The faith that gives courage. Twice he speaks of the courage of faith. I taught theology at Loyola, and responding to the atheistic critique of religion, one of the tropes that the neo-atheists would trot out is that faith, that's for cowardly people, people who need a Linus blanket. Well, then I think of Dorothy Day. I think of Oscar Romero, and I think of my Jesuit brothers who were murdered by a death squad in El Salvador. I think of St. Vincent de Paul and St. Francis of Assisi, who went off to meet with the Saladin during the days of the Crusades without any weapons. Saladin was bowled over by this humble man coming to meet him with a message of peace. That's courage. Courage of faith to witness to the kingdom of God. And in that second reading, Paul reminds us that our destiny is not here. We have not here a lasting home. One of my favorite verses, that's the letter to the Hebrews. Our destiny is beyond this life. And Paul says he lives with a tension. He'd rather go and be with Christ beyond this life, cast off his terrestrial body, and come into his heavenly home to be with Christ, where he says we'll all be judged according to what we did. But he's going to stay around as long as God has work for him to do in this life. I'm going to ask a personal question. If you feel comfortable, raise your hand. If not, that's fine. How many of you or your loved ones, so you can raise your hand either if it's you personally or your loved ones, have dealt with cancer? So quite a few hands, and I'm going to raise my hand too. And I mention that because 2 years ago, out of the blue, I got a diagnosis of terminal cancer. I just run in a triathlon. Out of the blue. And I'm sure some of you can tell similar stories. Fortunately, I'm in remission, and I imagine some of you are in remission. Let's pray for each other. But there's nothing like that, and I don't mean to limit to cancer. So others may have life-threatening conditions, cardiac, etc. There's a whole gamut of life-threatening conditions that remind us that this earthly body is temporary. We can always live one more day. But to receive such a diagnosis is to be reminded we're not going to be here forever. We know that. But a diagnosis of a life-threatening condition makes it very real. The courage of our faith to face crosses, like health crosses, and we know that our society is very polarized, trying to live our faith the context of this polarization, trying to witness to the kingdom of God locally here in this parish. How many small works can you think of that have fructified? I'm thinking heart to heart. I had my students make contact with heart to heart when Sister Mary Ann, several years ago, was the director. I know there's a new director. Little seeds that get planted in this parish that it's beyond our imaginings can grow fruit and touch people's lives. None of us should think that our gifts are too inconsequential. God can work through us. Whatever gifts we have, whatever talents we have, be it one talent, five talents, or 10 talents in that parable, God can work through us. Courage of faith. Awesome. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Let us call upon God, our hope and our strength, and rejoice in the faith that draws us together.
For a deeper love and appreciation of God's Word, that the Word of God will nourish and enrich us as we strive to be disciples of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our fathers on this Father's Day weekend, in gratitude for the love and the gifts of life they have bestowed on their families over the years, that they will receive our respect and devotion and God's divine blessings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our fathers who have died, that they may have the joy of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For growth in hope, that God's faithful love will sustain us in times of discouragement and empower us to persevere through difficult times with the confidence that God makes all things new, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewal of stewardship, that we may recognize and honor our gifts of time, talent, and treasure that God has entrusted to us, and place these at the service of God and one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, and for those for whom this Eucharistic celebration is remembered and honored, today, Mary Elizabeth Butita, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for Mary Elizabeth Butita, for whom this Mass intention is being said. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the personal intentions, we bring prayers for family members, perhaps who are indifferent or estranged from the faith. Prayers for the undocumented in Chicago or being forced out of shelters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Number 345, Seed Scattered and Sown. 345. Scattered and sown, wheat. gathered and grown. Bread broken and shared as one, the living bread of God. Vine, fruit of the land. Wine, work of our hands. One cup that is shared by all, the living cup, the living bread of God. Is not the bread we break a sharing in our Lord? Is not the cup we bless the blood of Christ outpoured? Eat, scattered and sown, wheat gathered and grown, bread broken and shared as one, the living bread of God. Wine, fruit of the land. Wine, work of our hands. One cup that is shared by all, the living cup, the living bread of God. A seed which falls on rock will wither and will die. The seed within good ground will flower and have life. Seed scattered and sown, wheat gathered and grown, bread broken and shared as one, the living bread of God. Vine, fruit of the land. Wine, work of our hands. One cup that is shared by all, the living cup, the living bread of God.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Gertrude and all the saints at whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Blaise our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you've summoned before you, in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Here.
Offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Our first communion hymn is number 355, In the Breaking of the Bread. Number 355. In the breaking of the bread, we have known him, we have been fed. Jesus the stranger, Jesus the Lord, be our companion, be our hope. Bread for the journey, strength for our years. Of struggle and tear, cup of salvation, fruit of the land, bless and receive now the work of our hands. Jesus the Lord, be our companion, be our hope. Bread of the promise, people of hope, life for the world, gathered at table, joined as his body, sealed in the Spirit, sent by the world. In the breaking of the bread, we have known him, we have been fed. Jesus the stranger, Jesus the Please join in our communion meditation hymn, number 446, Seek Ye First, 446. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and God's righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Alleluia. Alleluia. shall be given unto you. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. Alleluia, alleluia. You do not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. I invite all fathers, grandfathers, those who have exercised a fatherly role in somebody's life, please come forward for a special blessing. I invite all the people of God gathered here to extend their right arm and join in on the blessing of these men in gratitude for their fatherhood, all that they've done for children, grandchildren, and others who needed maybe a substitute father in their lives. And of course, we do remember our departed fathers, grandfathers as well. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The announcements are in the bulletin, so we won't read those. And the final blessing, may Almighty God bless everyone here, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to glorify the Lord with our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Number 502, Go Make a Difference, 502. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. We are the salt of the earth, called to let the people see the love of God in you and me. We are the light of the world, not to be hidden but be seen. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a friends, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. We are the hands of Christ, reaching out to those in need. The face of God for all to see. We are the light of hope. We are the voice of peace. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. So let your love shine on. Let it shine for all to see. Go make a difference in the world. And the Spirit of Christ will be with us as we go. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world.